Hello everyone. Welcome to this lecture series on systems biology. We will start this course with dynamical modeling using ordinary differential equations. Let's start this video with a very simple model. We have a reversible reaction with two molecules, A and B. We want to know how the concentrations of these two molecules will change with time. So we will create a model using differential equations. First, we write a differential equation for the rate of change in the concentration of A. This is a linear ordinary differential equation. On the left hand side of this equation, we have the derivative of A with respect to time. On the right hand side, we have a linear function involving both A and B. The first term, K1 into A, is the rate of the forward reaction. You must have noticed the minus sign here. I have used that because the forward reaction is decreasing the concentration of A. The second term is for the rate of the backward reaction. Here A and B are the dependent variables as they change with time, and T is the independent variable. Other than A, B and T, we also have two constants, K1 and K2. These two are the rate constants. Such constants in a differential equation are called the parameters. You must have noticed that this ODE is based on the law of mass action. I assume you remember the law of mass action. In brief, the law of mass action says that the rate of a reaction is proportional to the concentrations of the reactants raised to the power of their respective orders. I have written the second ODE. That represents the rate of change in the concentration of B. Well, now we have the model with two ODEs. But remember, we want to know the time evolution of A and B. So from the model, we have to get the temporal behavior of A and B. For that, we have three approaches. We can solve these ODEs analytically, the way you used to solve differential equations by paper and pen. Otherwise, we can also use a graphical method. We will learn the graphical method in another video. In this lecture, I will use the third approach, numerical solution of this system of ODEs. I will discuss the algorithm for the numerical solution in details in another video. For this model, here in this lecture, I will use a software and show you the results. I have used a software called JSIM to simulate our model. It is very easy to use. We have a video tutorial on JSIM. There are many other software for numerical simulation of ODE based models. You can use any of those. To solve the model, we must specify the initial condition. I have considered that at t equal to 0, that is the initial time point, A is equal to 10 molar and B is equal to 20 molar. We also need to specify the values of the parameters of the model. So K1 equal to 0.2 and K2 equal to 0.4. This graph shows the data generated by JSIM. With time, A increases but B decreases. Eventually, both of those flatten. Here is a quick question for you. Write the ODE for the rate of this particular equation using the law of mass action. Hope you are done with the problem. Every ODE based model has two assumptions. I will now discuss those assumptions. Our first assumption is that the system is homogeneous. Suppose in a cell we have red colored molecules and blue colored molecules. In this cell, all the molecules are well mixed. So the concentration of the molecules does not depend upon the location inside the cell. Our rate equation will have only one independent variable, time. But in the other cell, you can easily notice a gradient. Rate molecules are more on this side. That means the concentration of molecules depends upon the position inside the cell. So the rate of reaction will also depend on location. Therefore, here the position is also an independent variable. For this system, we cannot use ODE. We have to use partial differential equation. A partial differential equation will have two or more independent variables. The second assumption is that the system size is large. If we are dealing with molecules, then we must have a large number of molecules. Take the example of red and blue molecules again. Suppose these molecules are reactants of a reaction. When a red molecule hits a blue one, we have a product. On the left hand side cell, we have lots of these molecules. So if we observe this cell, almost every other moment there will be a reaction. So we will get a smooth increase in the product. Now take the other cell. Here we have only a handful of molecules. Right now, a red molecule may hit a blue one and then we'll have a product. But the next reaction may not happen immediately. We may have to wait for 1 hour or so that one red molecule diffuses close to the blue one and hits it. As the number of molecules is low, we are uncertain about the timing of the next event. This type of system is called a stochastic process. A stochastic process has randomness. We cannot use ordinary differential equations to model a stochastic process. Let's try to understand this assumption from another perspective. We have a cell of 1 micron size. The concentration of the red molecule is 10 millimolar. Approximately, that is equivalent to 24 into 10 to the power 6 molecules inside the cell. Now, when a reaction happens, one red molecule is consumed. So, the number of red molecules decreases by 1. That changes the concentration of the molecule to 9.9999998 millimolar. Hope I am not making a many mistake in the number of 9s. Anyway, this change from 10 millimolar to 9.9999998 is very small and can be considered as a smooth change. Now take the other cell. Here the system size is small. The concentration of the red molecule is only 10 nanomolar. Using Avogadro number, approximately that is equal to 24 molecule. When a reaction happens, the number changes by 1 and the concentration drops to 9.58 nanomolar. Numerically, that is an abrupt change. I hope you remember that we can use a differential equation only when the variables are changing smoothly. So for this cell with a low number of molecules, we cannot use ODEs. Let's jot down the key points of this video. By dynamical modeling, we capture the time evolution of a system. In differential equation based models, we use ordinary differential equations to represent rates of processes. Once we have the model, we can explore the temporal evolution of the system using three methods: analytical method, graphical method, and numerical method. And the final point, we have two assumptions behind every ODE based model. The system is homogeneous or well mixed, and the system is large. The number of molecules or the number of components in the system is very high.